a comprehensive look at trends, fund profiles, and more in Exploring ETFs.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to Exploring ETFs. I'm Neena Mishra, and today we are talking about artificial intelligence-related stocks and ETFs. So last week was a big week for this theme because last Monday, NVIDIA and OpenAI, they announced a strategic partnership under which the former will invest as much as $100 billion in the latter. So this investment is going to support new data centers with a capacity of at least 10 gigawatts of power. And according to the Financial Times, this 10 gigawatts of AI data centers could consume as much energy in a year as 10 million average U.S. households. So that's a lot, and that is according to the IEA estimates. And this computing capacity could cost as much as $600 billion, and of which about $350 billion could potentially be spent on NVIDIA's AI chips. So that much money may flow to NVIDIA. So NVIDIA's shares surged 4% after this announcement initially. Now, it is the largest company in the world. Its market cap now exceeds $4.5 trillion. And the demand for its cutting-edge AI chips shows no signs of slowing down. OpenAI, on the other hand, this is the largest privately traded company with a valuation at about $500 billion. So when it goes public, this could be the biggest IPO ever. And its ChatGPT currently boasts more than 700 million monthly users. But the company is losing money and its path to profitability remains quite unclear as of now. So NVIDIA has already invested in several AI-related companies. OpenAI is not the only one, and NVIDIA has a lot of cash on their balance sheet, so they can afford to invest. They recently invested $5 billion in Intel. They also hold a 7% stake in AI cloud computing company CoreWeave, whose shares are surging today. And NVIDIA is also an investor in Elon Musk's XAI. And but this investment, some analysts compared it to vendor financing schemes, subsidies that were seen during the dot-com bubble, and they talked about the circular nature of the deal. So then after surging on Monday, NVIDIA shares had slipped a bit later in the week, but they are surging again this week. And NVIDIA is not the only company which has invested in other AI-related startups. Microsoft has a huge stake in OpenAI. Amazon has invested in Anthropic, and many other mega-cap giants have invested in AI-related stocks. And unlike the dot-com bubble, today's leading players in the race to artificial general intelligence. So this is a race to artificial general intelligence where machines will be as smart or even smarter than human beings. And so in this race, the leading players are highly profitable, cash-rich companies that are making a lot of money and that can afford to invest a lot of money. And they are investing hundreds of billions of dollars to just stay ahead in this race. For them, the greater risk lies in under-investing and losing the race, not in overspending. And we know that AGI could potentially deliver massive productivity gains, and that is why it is very important for these companies to stay ahead in this
race. And further valuations are not as extreme, at least as yet, they are not as extreme as seen during the dot-com bubble. That said, some unprofitable tech companies, their valuations seem overstretched, and investors should be careful about investing in smaller unprofitable technology companies. And as far as AI trade is concerned, these big investments will likely result in handsome returns for some companies, while some may lose money. So there would be winners and losers ultimately, and it is difficult to predict as of now who will be the biggest winners. And in fact, some companies are already showing the positive impact of AI on their businesses. So that is why diversified exposure to AI beneficiaries via ETFs makes a lot of sense. And in fact, this year we have already seen that the AI trade has broadened, it has diversified beyond the Mag 7 group, which were seen as the most obvious winners. So companies like Palantir, which is up almost 140% this year, Oracle, which is up almost 70%, the shares have slipped a bit in the past week or so. But these have done much better than the Mag 7 group. Now let's take a look at three ETFs, AI related ETFs. So the first ETF that I'm highlighting, it is the oldest, we can call it the pure play AI ETF, because this made its debut in 2018. Invests in companies which are involved in artificial intelligence and big data analysis by GlobalX. The ticker symbol is AIQ, AI and Technology ETF. It invests in developed market stocks. 88 Holdings currently has $6 billion in assets. So largest AI-themed ETF, charges 68 basis points. If you want to learn more about this ETF, you can go to the quote page on Zacks.com. You can read our research report articles using the link. You can go to GlobalX web page for this ETF. You can read their research and look at the holdings. So as I mentioned, this also has a lot of international exposure, 69% to the US and then China, South Korea, Taiwan, Canada, etc. The top holdings are surprisingly Alibaba, which has done quite well lately. So that is why it is at the top of the list. And then you see Tesla, Google, and other holdings like Samsung, Tencent, Apple, Oracle, Palantir, etc. The second ETF that I'm highlighting is by iShares. iShares Future AI and Tech ETF. It invests in global companies which are involved in AI technologies. The ticker symbol is ARDY. 48 holdings currently. This is cheaper with 47 basis points expense ratio and has $1.6 billion in assets under management. Again, you can go to the quote page on Zacks.com, and from there, you can go to iShares web page, look at the holdings Vertiv, which is actually an industrial company involved in data centers. That is the top holding currently. Then SMCI, NVIDIA, AMD, Arista Networks. These are the other holdings in terms of country exposure. This has more exposure to the US compared to AIQ, about 83%, and then Japan, Taiwan, France, etc. The third ETF that I'm highlighting, Roundhill Generative AI and Technology ETF. The ticker symbol is CHAT, easy to remember. So this launched after ChatGPT went viral, and this is the world's first ETF focused on generative AI technologies. And ChatGPT is one of the most popular models which uses generative AI technology. This is an actively managed ETF, unlike the other two, has 47 holdings currently. 75 basis points expense ratio and 800 million in assets under management. And again, you can go to Roundhill webpage using the link on our quote page and learn more about this ETF and its holdings. NVIDIA, Alphabet, Oracle, Meta, Microsoft, Broadcom, and Tencent are the top holdings in this ETF currently. On the next slide, I have the competitive performance over the past year versus the QQQ ETF and the S&P 500 ETF. I've included both because the QQQ ETF, or its cheaper version, QQQM, is another way to invest in the AI theme. And you will see that chat ETF, it's the best performer over the past year. It's up a little over 60%. The other two ETFs that I talked about, AIQ and ARTYRT, they are up about 32% each. And QQQ is up, the NASDAQ 100 index is up about 23% over the past year, whereas the S&P 500 index is up about 17%.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out Zacks.com/promo for an interesting offer. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube video channel so that you do not miss anything. And I'll see you next week.